place where time stands still. In a rolling valley just beyond the hills, life is simple and you don't grow old. Where the misty meadow meets Soldiers Grove, we're working hard to pay our bills, getting through the daily grind by force of will. But the valley's calling and it's growing.
Every generation blames the one before. All of their frustrations come beating on your door.
Know that I'm a prisoner to all my father held so dear. And know that I'm a hostage to all his hopes and fears.
I was just gonna call Rodney and see why he wasn't here.
What is this? Everybody leaves.
I just wanna see. Take a picture.
Laura leaves, you leave. What are we on the wrong end of the
table? Mr. Roger Turnmeyer. Class of 45.
Right.
Bill Turnmeyer was 57. Now Rita is 52. All right.
I'm recording. This is video.
They sobered up. They just went in there to sleep.
Wait, there's some bars in back.
Need your attention.
Well, it worked out well for them. They're a little older, and when it started raining.
She's only 39 years old.
Phil Sireson called me and said, you can talk for 5 minutes. I don't know what you meant. I was not supposed to say any more matter. But anyway, we're all happy to be here for this occasion, and it's a wonderful thing. It's nice to see all the people for over all these years, and I really like it a lot.
Well, you're speaking on both sides of that class.
I represent our class in 1943. We had a motto that said, we live to serve, and I thought that was a really good motto.
No, the gas station was on the corner, the phone office was right across the street. His brother said, that's right, Dwayne.
That's right. First of all, I would like all of the people from the class of 1950 to please stand. Hey, can you hear me, Fred? Yeah. Fred's hard of hearing and Jim doesn't hear at all.
Jim Benson. Do I dare give him the mic or just let it blow?
Give me your notes.
You can't even see him.
Here, one is Merle Gardner, 2107 Glenview Lane, in Alaska, Wisconsin.
Thank you, Laura. I represent the class of 1956, and as Duane said, will my classmates stand up, please? Just having a great time. Of course, the other time was in 1951 when we had the big flood. That wasn't a nice time, but it was quite an experience for me. I didn't like everybody Harrison Page. We got the motor off and they lost the boat. The boat went on down the river. So the rest of that day, we all stayed in Harris's tavern. I was only 14, so don't... Just like that, that restaurant went just completely. You couldn't even see anything. It was gone. Boy, it was sad, right? You know, it worked hard to build up here.
When I graduated and went on, I was proud of being a Soldiers Grove boy. And I was glad to move back in the area. And today, sometimes, I'm proud of being in Soldiers Grove right now. I'm the village president, and some days it's not so nice. But it was nice to be part of this planning of this reunion. Phyllis and Monica and I worked very hard to get things out.
There were 29 in my class originally. I think 9 of them were here today, the last.
Say that I have met so many of my dear friends and people here. I'm getting a little long in the tooth. I hope Sully Dull didn't leave because he's older than I am.
And, now, Monica. She's been waiting for this all day because she just loves to run up at the mouth.
Please follow up, you know what. Class of 60, we had, I believe, 10 or 11 of us show that, more kids. So I just want to thank everybody for coming because we were really surprised. So thank you.
But I think there was 28 of us in our class, and I think we've lost Ronnie Scrady and Bonnie Gander are the only two, as far as I know. Are there?
The only thing I can remember is our class trip going to Chicago and the boys throwing water balloons out of the upstairs building, the window of the Hilton Hotel with our teachers, and it was so good to see John Schick. He looks, I said when I went to school, his feet looked so big, and I was scared to death. His feet didn't look near as big today, and I wasn't afraid of him.
Well, I guess all I can say is we were the freshmen, the last class of Soldiers Grove, and we have about 6 here, which I'm proud to say. They're great friends, girls and guys, and Linda and Barb and Joanne. Glad to see everybody. What a great turnout. John Schick still scares us. But
I can follow all the previous speakers. Give me so many ideas, I don't know where to start, and I wouldn't know where to stop. First off, they said, well, all the members of the 1940 class, please stand up. I think they're standing. We did enjoy each other, and we enjoyed Soldiers Grove. I dearly love it. As my wife says, when we hit, coming down from Reedstown, when we hit that valley, I said, even the air is better, isn't it? We took a lot of pictures, portraits of people here in Soldiers Grove. We were with her in Minneapolis at a wedding about a month ago, and she is writing her life story of life in Soldiers Grove. I'm waiting for it.
down the hall. And if Mr. Tess were here, we'd say, Merlin, have a beer. Students of soldiers grow high.
Time stands still.